To help us understand dynamic range, let's first define the term luminance. Luminance is basically a measure of the intensity of light per unit area. And this is again kind of accounting for also the light traveling in a given direction. So anytime light is hitting any surface area, the direction it's coming in from and the luminous intensity per unit square area of that region is what we're looking for, and that's what the measure of luminance is. And it's measured in candela per meter square, CD over M squared. To help us quantify this, let's look at the whole range of luminance. Now, I know we've in the past always looked at a black and white image or a range of 0 to 1 or 0 to 255 in a different set of numbers, but now we're going to look at it in terms of luminance on a surface or an object or a scene. And in this case, let's look at these values. And again, basically, I'm showing you this is a log plot going from 8, 6, 4 to 0, minus 10, minus 4, and minus 6. So, of course, that's why it kind of has a linear thing. But these are, again, numbers that are much more in detail, kind of showing you things about what's happening in an image. And I've just now marked in this range, basically an indoor sunlight. Sunlight is much brighter. And in fact, there's even something much even brighter than that. Indoor images would have these types of ranges here. So this point is basically showing sunlight. This would be indoor. These are the kind of images we looked at it. If the scene was lit by just moonlight directly captured, that's what we would have. And of course, this is starlight. Now, one thing to note, the human vision system can measure static contrast ratio. That is being able to kind of see the range at any moment when I'm looking at a scene from 100 to 1. 10 raised to 2 to 1. And again, the human eye in a static case can also adjust itself by about 6.5 f-stops. Remember the term of f-stops when we looked at from the camera world, when we actually look at what were the f-stops, and we looked at a variety of ways of what happens, and that basically means is how wide the aperture is opening up that allows us to capture more light or less light depending on the size of the aperture. Now, I do categorize this in two different ways. One, I'm talking about static contrast ratio. Now, another one is dynamic contrast ratio. That is when, of course, the scene is dynamically changing. And in this case, a human vision system can actually do much better. And in fact, we see a range from 1 million, 10 raised to 6, to 1. And basically, this can be captured with about 20 different f-stops. So you notice the range goes from 6.5 to 20 when we go from static to dynamic. Now, the big difference that I want to point out between static contrast and the static scene basically is nothing is changing. Or dynamic is when the illumination in the scene is changing. Now, this could be because the scene is dynamically changing or somebody is changing the lighting conditions. And this could be, again, the sun is moving around, there are shadows and stuff like that. So that's the difference. Of course, human eye system, as we've talked about before, is a pretty impressive bit of technology, and it can adapt quite quickly to a variety of shades. And again, something to think about when you start thinking about the human saccade system, and I encourage you to look at that kind of stuff on the web because it allows you to kind of adapt very quickly from one brightness to the other. Now, partly what we are trying to do with this representation of dynamic range is to create images that will allow us to actually capture dynamic range in one static image that actually is somewhat similar to what our human vision system can do. By moving our eyes around in saccades and stuff like that, we can see a lot of dynamic range, and our eyes adapt very much to bright and low light situations, and we can see much more detail. Of course, cameras at present cannot do this, and that's one of the questions for computational photography, is how do we kind of bring in the computation to make it do the adaptation to what it's seeing in the light and being able to capture images. And of course, at the end of it, we want to create sometimes just a static image that captures it. You'll see more examples of this as we continue talking more.